These new purifier designs rival any technology our people have previously conceived. The replication data is the sort that allows accurate duplication of one's consciousness. Phoenix's personality may be accurate.
How accurate?
Within the 99th percentile.
So there is a chance for discrepancy.
Quite a minuscule one.
And in a lifetime, how many choices does that variation impact? Who would you be with such a difference in the decisions you've made? Keep a watchful eye on Phoenix. If he is to help us, I want to know who he is.
You and I have stood shoulder to shoulder, blades thrumming in the heat of battle countless times. And now, you lead the Protoss. I well with pride at the mere thought of it.
I was chosen to represent the hierarchy by the remaining Judicators and the clans of the Narazim. I am still honored by their choice.
Tassadar must be proud as well.
Tassadar is gone, Phoenix. He fell, bravely sacrificing for his people. He saved us from annihilation.
What? It cannot be. And Ire? Fallen to the Zerg as well?
It has.
How long have I lingered in stasis, becoming this Dragoon?
Do you know of the Purifier program, Phoenix?
Of course. The greatest Templar minds replicated. Dangerous machines that had to be shut down.
They were shut down, but we have never ceased the research, and still have tried to find ways to replicate our greatest Templar, to use that ancient technology.
Why do you tell me this?
We are facing a war like none we have seen before. We will need you in the days ahead. Maybe even the Purifiers.
Then my blades are yours, old friend.
We have acquired new robotic support technology for review.
May Rashagal light the path to victory.
Seeing Phoenix once more perplexes me. I feel sadness, but I should feel joy.
It is said the warrior Phoenix was felled by the Queen of Blades. This approximation is not Phoenix, but he is a reminder of the loss you suffered.
His voice, thoughts, his very presence. He describes memories we shared with such vivid recollection. Every instinct I have tells me that this is my friend, but all logic defies it.
We of the Narazim often ponder whether our people are the sum total of their experiences, or are more than them, a truth lingering inside us. In time, we shall see if this Phoenix has his own truth, or is little more than a flawed forgery.
See the master construction of the Xel'Naga now. They're understanding that energy, essence, and information are all one. Each interchangeable, each mutable.
Then you uncovered the information Zeratul foresaw within this keystone.
I have. From what I understand, it will lead us to Ulnar.
Ulnar? It is a place of myth. A realm whispered of in our legends.
The homeworld of the Xel'Naga. I believe the Keystone can project its location.
Show me, Kerax.
Must be in error.
The Altarian Rift.
That is impossible. Nothing could survive within such unrelenting forces. It appears I have failed you, Hierarch.
I do not believe so, Kerax. It is said that the Xel'Naga came from a place where no life should be. This aligns with Zeratul's prophecies. We will go in. Make preparations at once. Zeratul, many thought you mad, and yet once more, you have seen truer than us all. The Keystone leads us into the Altarian Rift, to the Xel'Naga home of Ulnar. It is my destiny to carry your mantle, old friend. I will wake the Xel'Naga and honor you.
It is hard to believe we stand above Ulnar, the home of the Ihanri, the Xel'Naga. The Judicators theorized the Xel'Naga left Ire to return to a place such as this. It is said they slumbered through the ages.
Zeratul believed the artifact would lead us unto hope. The Xel'Naga may be the hope he spoke of.
If the legends are true, then the Xel'Naga are below, awaiting their children to awaken them.
Then let us hope so.
Kerax has utilized data from Glacius to bring the robotic sentinels online. Use them wisely, Hierarch.
Phoenix, you appear distressed.
Apologies, Hierarch. I have been pondering the events that brought me here. I've discovered there are holes in my memory. Battles recorded here in the ship's archives that I should be able to recall, but cannot.
What is it you have found?
Records of my defeat at Antioch and being revived as a dragoon. But this body, it is clear to me that I am no dragoon.
There is more to those records, Phoenix. But what you uncover may not be desirable.
I am willing to face the truth, old friend, however difficult it may be.
Then I hope you find the answers you seek.
How Zeratul foresaw the Keystone would lead us here is uncanny. It is now clear that it was this device's primary purpose.
Zeratul was in touch with an expression of reality beyond my understanding.
This place should not exist. It defies all decrees of science, shatters all understanding of astral mechanics.
I once thought we Protoss had reached the pinnacle of attainable knowledge. I was a fool. There is far more in the galaxy than exists within Protoss understanding, friend Kerax. I know this now.
How Zeratul...
I was...
Hierarch, it appears we...
Zeratul believed. And so will I.
The Spear of Adun's sensors have located what appears to be an access way into the temple. Our starships are prepared to move on your command.
Here lies the resting place of the Xel'Naga. We must find a way to unseal this access way if we are to awaken them. Grand Preserver, what do you know of the temple in the depths below?
Only myth, legend. Here upon Ulnar, the destined races will seek ascension. Their very presence shall open the way forward. I believe these celestial locks are the key. Our forces should claim them in the hopes the way forward presents itself.
Hylok, the Tal'Darim are here. They are taking control of the Celestial Locks.
The voice's demands are clear. Keep the temple sealed.
As long as they control the locks, the secrets of the temple will remain hidden from us.
Warriors, engage the enemy and reclaim the locks. Amon will not have his victory so easily.
The skies await.
Our stargates can now warp in phoenixes. They are extremely mobile and effective at engaging our enemy across long distances.
For honor.
I will comply.
Once Amon's forces have been defeated, our warrior's presence should allow us to lay claim to the lock.
On the wings of justice, I stalk through the stars. La Farosh.
You have not enough minerals.
I will comply.
Azul du Templari. For honor.
I walk the shadow path.
is now ours. These energy patterns indicate once we control the other four, the temple will open.
Servants are moving to seize a lock. Teleport successful. Successful.
Our blades.
Teleport successful. Teleport successful. Teleport successful.
Anan for call.
Understood.
For honor.
I will comply. On the way to justice.
The Tal'Darim have deployed a titanic warp prism. If its core is similar to our own, the reactor is made of pure solarite. If possible, we should destroy it and claim the reactor to enhance our solar core.
On.
Understood. On the wings of justice.
You have not enough men. You must construct additional pylons. You have not enough minerals.
Anan Poko!
You must construct additional pylons.
Stars.
These forces are inbound to our nexus point.
It is done. I am warping the vessel's cargo aboard for further study.
I spot the stars. On the wings of justice.
Shazul, engaging the enemy.
Time for battle. Xel'Naga, triumph!
I will comply.
On the wings of justice.
Successful. Well, Xel'Naga, cry all. For honor.
I will comply. I stalk through the stars. Not for Rosh.
Shazul, to the glory.
Understood. On the waves of justice.
Engaging the enemy.
For honor.
Successful.
Sanpoko. For honor.
Xerofek, cry on.
On the wings of justice.
Understood.
I will comply.
Strike.
It appears a lock has fallen to the enemy. We will need to retake it quickly.
Successful.
Time for battle.
Successful. Teleport successful.
Five locks have been captured, Hierarch. The access way is opening.
It seems Amon's forces have drawn back. I sense only a great stillness from within the temple.
Then we have succeeded. It will not be long before we see what fate has in store for us.
I'm afraid the Spear of Adun will not be able to assist you inside the temple. Please be careful, Hierarch.